dan dikasihi Allah SWT. Apa yang anda perlu buat? Pertamanya, anda ada Google Drive. Anda kena open lah. Anda pergi sebelah kanan atas. You are going to see whether you are already login or not. So, if you can see over here, I already login. If you not login, then that's mean you need to login into your Google account. If you fail to do so, that's mean you forgot your password lah, perhaps. So, I may advise you to create a new account lah. Otherwise, you are going to wasting a lot of time. Okay, the next one. After you finishing doing the login, dah masuk dalam login ni, dia akan ada drive, bawah ni ada new, betul tak? Tekan new tu. Dah tekan new? Tekan new folder. Apa dia? New folder. Dah tekan? Bagi nama. Give the name of the folder. So, in this example, so I'm going to give the name of knowledge. Knowledge about, sorry, saya tulis questionnaire. Questionnaire. Oh, sorry, saya tulis study lah. Study ADMW. Contoh. Ni saya bukan nak bahan kawan kita tadi, tapi saya nak bagi contoh je lah. Katakanlah saya menjadi beliau dalam nak membuat kajian ni. So, saya just buat je. Satu folder namanya study ADMW. Dah buat? Kalau dah buat, tolong klik kepada that folder. Please go inside the folder. If you want to go to the inside of the folder, you must double click on the folder and then you are already go inside the folder. You go inside the folder already? Okay, good. And then go to the new. And then go to the Google form. And then you click the Google form, another tab are going to be appear. Something like this. Untitled form are going to be appear. For those yang dah siap untuk buat benda ni, the next step yang you need to do is basically you name your form. Contoh kat sini saya buat knowledge postpartum. Postpartum. Salah je? Tak kisahlah. Bukan kajian saya pun. Okay, so dah siap? Dah bagi nama dah? Belum? Yes, puan. Kalau nak buat dekat NMRR lah, kalau nak hantar untuk etika, anda kena ada clearance dan anda kena jelaskan lah seperti consent, PIS, patient information sheet and so on and so forth. Tapi kalau anda buat untuk tujuan dalaman, untuk tujuan latihan, untuk tujuan akademik, mungkin benda tu boleh difikirkan balik lah. Tak ambil masa dan sebagainya kan. Baik, saya just ajar mana yang betul by right. So, konon-konon anda ada beberapa section. So, macam mana nak create section? So, how you want to create numbers of section? So, the reason of section is because I want to divide this study into numbers of chapter ataupun bahagian. So, the first one will be consent. The second one will be demographic. The third one will be your DV, iaitu knowledge. So, I'm going to click this button over here. We call it as add section. So, perhaps you can click this one. One time and then two times. So you have three section already, which is the section 1 of 3, 2 of 3 and then 3 of 3. So far so good? Boleh follow? Okay. So untuk section 1 of 3, kat sini kita akan letak consent lah. Consent. Consent ni anda akan tulis lah. Do you agree? Contoh do you agree to participate in this study? So as simple as that. Okay, and then after that, you are going to click the required and then all of the respondent need to answer whether yes or no. Okay, so far so good? Okay, dah siap? Maka the next one, I'm going to have the next section. So section number 2, I'm going to put here as a demographic and then the third section, I'm going to name here as the knowledge. Knowledge, Done. Okay, the next part is inside the agree to participate this study ni, I'm going to click the 3 dot down here, near the required icon. Kat bawah ni kita ada required kan? Sebelah ni ada 3 dot. Okay, anda akan klik 3 dot ni. Go to section based on answer. Saya ulang. Pertama, saya ulang balik dengan cara macam mana tau? Nak nampak lebih dramatik lagi kan? Saya delete. Dramatik sikit. Saya delete terus. Bawa anda puas hati, betul? So, I'm going to repeat it again. First of all, create a folder. You create a folder already? Excuse. Okay, the next one, you are going to go inside your folder. And then the next one, you click the new icon, followed by the Google form. After you click the Google form, then a new tab are going to be open for you. And then you give the name of your form. Knowledge postpartum. Kalau salah je, minta maaf. I'm not inside the field. Ataupun saya pun tak pandai sangat bidang ni. Kemudian, I'm going to click this one. The icon here, add section. Because this is only a section 1. So, I'm going to click two times. So another sections are going to be open, and then I'm going to click another one. So another sections are going to be open. But somehow the question is gone. Correct or not? Dia hilang kan? Dia berada di bawah. Perlukah saya risau? Tak perlu. Eh? You need to worry? No need. Because you can create it. Okay? Just go over to your section and then you have the menu over here. The first menu is actually add a question. So you can click those plus icon to add a question. So my question is actually a consent. Eh? I agree to participate. Participate this study. Okay, dah siap, maka I'm going to make it as required. Okay, saya akan tulis yes dan saya akan tulis no. And then I'm going to click required. Required maksudnya apa? Wajib dijawab lah. Kalau dia tak jawab, dia tak boleh pergi ke next question. Okay, and then you are going to click the three dot down there. Near the required icon. Nampak tak? Nampak. Tekan butang go to section based on answer. Okay, done. After that, you are going to see something like this. Yes. Siapa yang jawab yes, dia akan pergi ke section yang berikutnya. Section berikutnya adalah section 2. Ataupun section 2 kita apa? Section 2 kita tadi adalah demographic. Okay, kalau siapa yang jawab no, dia akan pergi ke mana? Submit form. Eh? Maknanya kalau dia kata no, tak payah participate in our study, then they can just submit the form. Eh? That's mean she did not give her consent to participate in our study. Okay, as I mentioned before, the sections need to be used as demographic, and then the last but not least is the knowledge. Okay, done. Siap eh? Boleh? Okay, next one, go to your demographics. Inside the demographic here, saya nak anda createkan, saya bagi soalan ini kepada tuan-tuan dan puan-puan supaya tuan-tuan dan puan-puan fikirkan dan buat supaya tuan-tuan dan puan dapat apply knowledge yang kita telah pelajari tadi. So, I'm asking you to generate at least 5 different demographic questions that are suitable to see the correlation with the knowledge of the respondent. Yeah? 5 different questions with regard to the demographic factors. Contohnya macam gender, age, something like that lah. Gender mustahil lah kan. Postpartum ni lelaki tak terlibat kan. Jadi tuan-tuan dan perempuan boleh berikan 5 contoh demographic. Silakan, saya bagi masa 3. So I'm just going to simulate it to you how I'm going to do it. So the first one, contoh macam ni, postpartum kan. Postpartum memang tak terlibat pun lelaki dengan perempuan. So the best thing to do is actually asking them whether they have a good educational background or not. So saya akan tanya, highest education. Contoh, highest education level. So this one is actually the type of question dia adalah multiple choice. So I'm going to use as diploma, advanced diploma. Okay. Okay, yang the next one is degree or more. Just as simple as that. Eh? Saya malas, saya tak nak tekan butang plus ni. Saya boleh tekan butang duplicate. Eh? So I'm just going to duplicate. So the next one is race. So race saya letak 3 lah. Malay. Okay, Chinese. Okay, last kali adalah Indian. Okay, perhaps maybe another one is others. Okay, simple as that. Dah 2. Okay, yang ketiga adalah umur. Umur, age. So, the age are going to be as a short answer. And then this one, I'm going to specify as response validation. Where I'm going to specify number is number. Eh? Number is number. And then put some error messages lah. Please insert number. So that when people did not insert any number, please insert number. So, there will be prompt some queries eh, with regard to their question. Okay, the next one saya duplicate lagi. Apa lagi yang penting? Years of experience. I'm going to use the same thing. Number is number. And then the last but not least, I'm going to give the question with regard to their training experience. Did you have any formal training in your job with regard to the postpartum hemorrhage, eh? PH lah saya tulis. Eh? Sorry lah eh, kalau dia tak menepati citarasa ahli dalam bidang berkenaan, saya minta maaf sebab mungkin saya just buat secara mudah sahaja. Okay, this is the example. I have 5 question already. Highest education level, race, age, years of experience, and last kali, a very simple questions that ask them whether they have a formal training or not with regard to the postpartum hemorrhage. Eh? That's all. Siap ke tak siap? Dah siap. So, pertama kita ada consent. Kedua, kita akan ada demographic. And then yang ketiga kita akan ada knowledge. So knowledge ni usually some of you will be constructing your knowledge question based on Likert scale or question quizzes based. So saya gunakan yang Likert scale lah. So I'm going to tick the required and then make the following statement. I'm going to put something like this. Please rate your answer based on the statement below. Using the scale provided. Okay, selesai. So I have 1, 2, okay, and then 3, kemudian 4, and then last but not least is 5. Okay, done already. Siap dah. And then I have a few statement lah. Yang ni nanti kena tanya dengan sahabat saya lah, puan yang berkenaan. Puan ni buat postpartum hemorrhage, dia ada soalan-soalan ni. Ada berapa soalan puan? Yang puan punya kajian ni, ada berapa soalan ni agak-agak? 10 soalan eh? Ada tak soalan tu sekarang? Yang bukan demografik, yang untuk knowledge. Ada, boleh saya dapatkan? Contoh. Online eh? Dia apa, soft copy? Tak ada. Tak ada lagi sekarang ah. Tak penalize lagi. Okay, never mind lah. Saya akan cuba buat sebagai contoh sahaja. Nanti you all akan gunakan lah ya. Ambil contoh eh. Saya ambil contoh. Saya akan ada statement eh. Statement 1. Okay. Kemudian saya akan ada statement 2. Okay. Oleh kerana saya malas nak type perkataan statement ni, saya gunakan Excel. Okay, statement 1, statement 2. Okay, ada berapa statement tadi sahabat kita bagi tahu? 10 ya. So saya akan ambil 10 lah. So I have 10 statement over here. And then I'm going to copy and paste eh. Okay. So ini contoh. Statement tu maknanya ayat penyata lah kan? Postpartum hemorrhage berlaku disebabkan oleh risiko contoh. Obesity, contohlah. Ini saya tak pastilah, kita tak betul. Nanti kena tengok literature dan tanya kepada experts. So kalau kata dia adalah bersetuju, dia kena jawablah bersetuju. Okey, dah sudah. Maka ada lagi satu komponen yang mungkin tuan-tuan dan puan tertanya-tanya. Macam mana question A saya boleh ada skala, betul tak? Skala 1 sampai 5 kan? Skala tu dibuat menggunakan Microsoft Word. Guna Microsoft Word, lepas tu print screen. Okey, saya tunjukkan dulu. Saya akan cerita benda ni sampai pukul 9.45 sahaja. Lepas tu saya akan pergi kepada descriptive statistics. Lepas tu saya akan tinggalkan you all dengan video ni. Nanti you pandai-pandailah buat. Okay, esok saya nak tengok setiap orang ada online form tersendiri. Boleh? Siapa yang tak ada, nanti ketua kelas tak bagi dia masuk dalam dewan. Faham? Ni kerja rumah awak. Buat online question air. Boleh tak boleh ni? Boleh ya? Okay. Alright. So, the next one that I'm going to simulate it to you is basically making a scale, buat skala. Skala saya akan follow sahabat kita punya kajian tadi. Saya buat simple je. 5x2 table, which is as follow. Strongly disagree. Okay, lagi apa? Disagree, lagi? Neutral, lagi? Agree, lala saya cakap seorang eh. Strongly agree. Okay, kemudian kita 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Follow ke tak follow ni? Follow ke tak follow ke, unfollow ke, unfriend dah? Unfriend eh. Tak apa, kejap lagi kita rehat ya. Saya tahu you all dah berkicap dah ni. Okay, ini contoh saya punya skala. So saya boleh letak color. Contohnya saya letak color lah seperti yang tuan-tuan puan lihat pada question S saya tadi. Saya ada letak color kan. So I'm going to use some shading lah over here. So let's say I put some shaded orange color over there. And then I'm going to put some shaded yellow color over there. And then put some neutral with green color over here. And then I'm going to put the agree with some bluish color. And then last kali strongly agree with some violet color lah ya. Ataupun orange lah. This is the example. And then I'm going to perform some sort of print screen lah. So saya dah print screen. So after you perform that print screen, you can click those symbols. Kat sini ada satu simbol. Simbol ini dinamakan sebagai insert image. So I'm going to insert my image. So my image is actually inside the apa nama ni tadi, screenshot lah, screenshot yang berkenaan. So I'm going to open and then the image will be inserted siap. So saya nak tuan-tuan puan buat perkara ini esok, mesti semua ada. Boleh? nanti tengoklah video ni sekejap lagi saya try publish. Alright, that is the simplest way to publish and also set up your questionnaire. Jika tuan-tuan dan puan nak lihat apakah questionnaire yang telah tuan-tuan dan puan lakukan, boleh klik butang Freemason ni, gambar mata sebelah ni. Gambar Dajjal ni. Dah. Klik preview and then you are going to observe something like this lah. Agree to participate this study, let's say the respondent say no, when they click next, they are going to submit the button. Ini contoh. So when they click yes, they are able to answer the following questions lah, which is the first one is the demographic, ada 5 soalan. And then after the 5 different question, they are able to answer the another question with regard to their knowledge. Contoh, ini contoh saja, years of experience is actually 32. Okay, and then I'm going to click next. So we have another one is the statement. Ini sama macam soalan saya tadi. Okay, this is the example. I need all of you capable of doing this. By tomorrow, all of you must have it. Alright, itu sahaja yang saya nak cerita. Ada apa-apa soalan? Memang ada nak tanya. Tapi tolong buatlah sekejap lagi. Nanti masa rehat, kalau anda nak tanya pun boleh. Saya make a repetition. You just click on the preview button over here. Dia akan tulis perkataan view form. Tengok kat atas ni, ada tak tulis view form? Cuba klik kat mata tu. Cuba klik kat mata sekarang. Dia keluar tak view form ni? Keluar kan? So form inilah yang anda akan share kepada orang untuk jawab. However, this form or this link are quite lengthy, panjang. Jadi anda kena pendekkan dia. So the best thing to do that is using the URL shortener. So I'm going to copy. Okay, you see? I'm going to copy this one. And then followed by any URL shortener. Contoh URL shortener ni apa? URL shortener ni akan memendekkan apa yang panjang tadi. Contoh yang paling senang saya boleh pakai bit.ly, bit.ly and so on and so forth. So kalau saya pergi kepada bit.ly, I can shorten the link. Okay? So ini adalah tugasan kamu. Esok kamu akan buat. Sekian. Terima kasih.